Ebony Vichev, are you ready to share your screen?
Yeah, I am ready to share my screen and I will run my video. Yes, I will share.
Okay, you have 15 minutes to present your work, followed by 5 minutes of questions from the audience.
Yeah, yeah. I can start?
Yes.
My report is devoted to the Tazgarian approach to the artificial general intelligence. It combines the following important topics. First, it's explainable and works in terms of subject domain ontology. Second, it efficiently solves a wide range of tasks that are formulated in terms of executable specifications, which automatically generate algorithms of these task solutions. And third, it models a cognitive process, which are considered as a special type of tasks. And in particular, it models a physiological theory of functional systems of brain activity. Let us consider artificial general intelligence. AGI is not anthropomorphic. Deep learning has shown that human nature is not necessarily prerequisite for solving cognitive tasks of a variety of degree of complexity. According to AGI, it is to some degree can be potentially possessed by both a person or a living organism with a highly developed central nervous system or in an abstract robotic system. Famous developers of AGI gave the following definitions of AGI. Ben Gertzen, general intelligence is the ability to achieve challenging goals in challenging environments. Shane Lang and Marcus Hutter. Intelligence is measured by the agent's ability to perform successfully in a wide range of environments. P1. Intelligence is the ability of a system to adapt to its environment, working with insufficient knowledge and resources. As a result, in the famous book on AGI, Strong Artificial Intelligence, published by Sberbank, the following definition of AGI was given. It is the ability to solve cognitive tasks in general, acting purposefully, adapting to environment through learning, minimizing risk, and optimizing losses to achieve their goals. In this report, I can propose that task-driven approach satisfies the definition of AGI and also provides an anthropomorphic solution or provides a variety of tasks. Let us consider the informal definition of the task-driven approach. The task is defined if its formulation contains an indication of the subject domain to which the task belongs, domain ontology, knowledge about the subject domain, initial data, and hypothesis. To what request question formulated in the task we should receive an answer? The criteria for satisfying the request to determine in which case we can consider the answer to the request question was obtained. In what context should the answer to the request question be sought? What is the goal we pursue in solving the problem? That is, what we expect from the result and what is consequences? Task-driven approach supports that the purpose of artificial intelligence is to automate the solution of tasks. Therefore, task requests must be formulated in terms of executable specifications. If we take the signal definability of computations as a basic model of computations, in accordance with the book of Virchow, definability and computability, no suggestion, 2000 year. And checking the truth of signal formulas on the constructive model and its list of superstructure, then this gives an algorithm for solving the task as a general recursive function. If we use a delta zero formulas for the task specifications, then the task solution can be obtained by primitive imposed functions. If the primitives of the language are polynomially computable, then and a specification of the task use sigma zero formulas, then the solution of the task can be obtained by in polynomial time. The formal definition of the task in terms of semantic modeling is defined as follows. It is assumed that we have a multi-sorted constructive model together with this superstructure on M, which is kind of a basic computer. The task, the main model under consideration is formulated in the signature of the predicate calculus language of this very basic constructive model, together with its list of superstructure as a set of sigma definitions. It has sigma formulas and sigma terms of this language. A query to the domain model is also defined as a sigma formula. By the solution of this of the task, it means a set of constants that makes the sigma query formula true. The truth of sigma query formula is the criterion for the task solution. Let us consider the task concept in cognitive science. A generalization of the task concept in cognitive science is the concept of a goal. The goal cannot be achieved without criterion of its achievement. Otherwise, it can always be considered that it has already been achieved. Therefore, the formulation of the goal should always be accomplished by the definition of the criteria for the goal achievement. Achievement of the goal gives a certain result. The goal and the criteria for the goal achievement must match each other as k to a log, as shown on the picture. Here, blue indicates a goal, for example, trust, and red indicates a substance that needs to be found to each trust. Whether this substance quenches trust or not is determined by the criteria for the goal achievement, indicated by red. If the criterion is triggered, then the goal is achieved, and the trust and the red substance is found. Then we get the result, the quenching trust. The only physiological theory in which achievement of the goal and getting the result is considered as a task solution by Lebrun is the theory of functional systems by Petrov and Michinot. This theory also reveals the physiological mechanisms of the goal achievement task solution by Lebrun. Perhaps the most dramatic moments in the history of the Lebrun study is the fixation of attention on the action itself and not on its results. We can assume that the result of the Grassmann reflex will not be the reflex itself, but the totality of apparent stimuli, which corresponds to signs of the grasp object. It is was written by Potop and Michinot. The totality of apparent stimuli is the criterion for achieving the goal in the functional system theory. Therefore, a necessary condition for the purposefulness behavior of an intelligent agent is goal setting, which includes the criteria for the goal achievement. According to Petr Kuzmich and Anokhin, the certain mechanism functional systems that provide purposefulness behavior have the same architecture. The formal model of this architecture is presented in the paper follow. Architecture. afferent synthesis. The initial stage of behavioral act of any degree of complexity is an afferent synthesis, which includes the synthesis of motivational excitement, memory, situation, or trigger implementation. Motivational excitement. Goal setting is carried out by an emerging need, which is transformed into motivational excitement. Motivational excitement retrieves from the memory. Also, the entire sequence and hierarchy of results that must be obtained for the goal achievement. Situation and trigger implementation. When interacting with the experience from the memory, situational orientation determines what and how it can be done in a given environment to achieve the goal. Trigger orientation is also situation, but it only relates to the time and place of the goal achievement. Decision making stage. The stage of afferent synthesis, motivational excitement, can extract from the memory several ways for the goal achievement. At the decision making stage, only one of these ways is chosen, a specific action plan. Acceptance of operation results. Motivational excitement also retrieves from the memory the entire sequence and hierarchy of results that must be obtained to carry out the action plan. The sequence and hierarchy of results is called the acceptor of action results. Reinforcement and authorization stage. If the behavioral act leads to the goal achievement, then the entire sequence of actions is reinforced and recorded in the memory. Since the real situation is always somewhat different from the situations that were retrieved from the memory, then inevitably there may be mismatches between the expected results and actually coming in this orientation about the real action results. In this case, the restructuring of operant synthesis occurs and a new decision is made to achieve the goal. From the point of view of the Grine approach, the task solution by the Grine is formulated as follows. The main model is the external goal in which purposefulness behavior is carried out. The request to the main model is a need that must be satisfied. Let us denote it by the predicate zero. By solution of the problem, we mean an object A or situation and unit of external goal perceived by the set of afferent stimuli of object A, which makes the predicate zero true, which leads to satisfaction of the need. The truth of a predicate is the criterion of the task solution. There can be several specific plans to achieve the goal that makes the predicate true. And the decision-making stage, it chooses one of these plans. Let us consider the scheme of functional systems in terms of probabilistic causal relations. To do this, we first define a probabilistic causal relation. It has satisfied the following two conditions. First, Cartwright condition on probabilistic causal relations. If we have a relation R is equal to H1 and etc. HK follow H0, then its conditional probability is strictly greater than the conditional probability of its subrules containing strictly less conditions. Second requirement, requirement of maximal specificity. I will not define it formally, but informally, it means that a probabilistic causal relation produces maximum available information that that can increase the conditional probability of the rule. We can prove that in this case, predictions of such causal relations are carried out without contradictions. This was proved in the following paper. The scheme of functional system works in accordance with its architecture described above. I will provide the most illustrative computer experiments which demonstrate the work of our model of functional system. Let us consider an electronic model of nematode developed at the Institute of Computer Science Systems by Poliana, which makes into account, which takes into account the sequential work of muscles and their interrelation, friction on the surface, and other elements of the structure of the nematode. We took this model and put into it our model of functional system. It turns out that the nematode can learn its natural movements within 100 or 100 feet around samples. And after that, it finds its natural movement. In the next experiment, we model a group of mouse, each of which has its own functional system, and at the same time, they can exchange its experience in the form of rules given on the right. As a result, they can learn to each other rather quickly. There are main books and articles which were devoted to this team. Thank you for your attention.
Vitir, thank you so much. Now we will proceed with a question from the audience. If anyone has any question, please raise your hand.
Hello. My question is the following. There are multiple things that can be goals. For example, I can have a goal to reach a specific situation, which is somewhat simple to solve, or I can have a goal to become rich, which is not so simple to solve. How do you plan to deal with these more difficult kinds of goals, just like becoming rich? Is there a way to specify that, or how the system can cope with these kinds of goals?
Yes, the system can be made an extent with utility function. And if we will use utility function, we can include several goals. So it is possible.
Okay, thank you.
Another question? Okay, Vitir, thank you so much for your talk.